Hello and welcome everyone, and happy Mother's Day to everyone, all you ladies, beautiful women of God. I know when you view this, Mother's Day will be over, but we still wanted to make sure we sent something special to you. We want to just let you know that as we discuss today, we've got Proverbs 31 women right in our midst. You've been with us all along, amen? So we just want to recognize you for who you are. You are a gift from God, and we thank God for you. Amen. Watch the broadcast, and I will see you right after. Praised, hallelujah. There is none like you, none to be compared unto you, Lord God. We thank you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on, just begin to lift him up. Begin to give him glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. I want to welcome everyone this morning. Welcome Facebook friends and family. We welcome you this morning. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Just join in with us, everyone, as we just begin to lift up the name of Jesus. To give him glory, to give him praise, to bless his name. Hallelujah. There is no God like the one we serve. Somebody say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. There is no God like Jehovah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. There is no God like Jehovah Rapha. There is no other healer. There is no other deliverer. Jehovah Shalom, there is no one else who can give us peace. None but the Lord God Almighty, hallelujah. El Shaddai, Almighty God. Woo, that's who we serve. Almighty God. He's mighty in all of his ways and all of his acts and all of his doing. My God. You know what? That's something to think about. That we serve not just a God, but we serve the God that has all power in his hand. He's got all power. Hallelujah. There's not another God. He is the only one true and living God. Hallelujah. That's the one that we praise. That is the one that we lift up. That is the one that we give glory to. Hallelujah. One of my favorite scriptures, you all know I say it all the time. He sits in the circles of the earth. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. And he reigns and he rules by the counsel of his word. He can say a word. Hey, glory to God. Just say a word. And that's it. And because he's almighty, because there's no God greater, that when he says a word, whatever word, other word that's been released, his word conquers, supersedes, overrides everything else. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So if there's a word that's been spoken against you, when God speaks a word concerning you, hallelujah, that settles it. That is it. It is done. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So it doesn't matter what has been said, what has gone after you, the word of God that says you're blessed and highly favored, the word of God that says I've already accepted you into the beloved, you're already mine, the word of God that says I am with you even until the ends of the earth, even until the ends of the world, when the world tries to tell you, you by yourself in this, honey. You know all this stuff that's going on. It's so much stuff that's going on. Yeah, it's so much stuff, but God is going on. Hallelujah. Don't ever let anybody you talking to allow the enemy to get the praise of the enemy to get the last word. Child, you know the devil is busy. You know what? I want the world to start saying, you know, God's children are busy. Woo, they busy, y'all. Hallelujah. He going around seeking whom he may devour. The children of God, they going around devouring, hallelujah, the things of the enemy. Hallelujah. So we win. We win. Woo! We win. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We serve a God that's chief. He's captain. He's ruler. Almighty. And we won. That deserves a praise. That deserves a hand clap. Oh, you mean I've won? You mean I don't have to wait to win? I've already won? We have already won. Yes, he has already gotten us the victory. Hallelujah. You can go and get your prize. Hallelujah. What's your prize? Happiness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. What's your prize? Healing. What's your prize? Peace. What's your prize? The goodness of the Lord is before you all the days of your life. That is your prize. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Come on, let's just thank God for that. Woo! We've won. We've won. We've won. Hallelujah. He's gotten us the victory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. I want to read this scripture. I want to read this scripture, Psalms 46. It says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place, the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. Say, God shall help me. Right early. Early in the morning, God is in my midst. Somebody needs to know this morning that God is in your midst. Hallelujah. Yeah, I feel this in the Holy Ghost, that somebody needs to just understand and be reminded that you think you're in the midst of chaos and confusion, but you need to know that that's just the right place for God. He abides in chaos and confusion. That's where he's at his best. Hallelujah. He loves calming storms. He loves telling storms to cease. God is in your midst to tell it to cease, to stop, in the name of Jesus. That's a promise from God. He's in our midst. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. He's in your midst to open up your airways in the name of Jesus, to open up to everything concerning your heart, concerning your lungs, concerning your respiratory system, in the name of Jesus. He is in your midst for complete healing and restoration in Jesus' name. The oil is being poured upon your head now in the mighty name of Jesus. We curse the plans of the enemy in Jesus' name. Every strategy you tried to use, losing her breath, not walking far and getting tired, you are a lie in Jesus' name. Healing is that woman's bread. In the mighty name of Jesus. So we thank you now, Lord God. You are a triumphant God. In Jesus' name, there is no residue of sickness or disease upon this woman. She breathes clearly the life and breath of God. In the name of Jesus. Receive that in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Somebody, you lift your hands before the Lord right now. Glory to God. And he's been plaguing you for months and plaguing you for the last 3 or 4 or 5 years. Something concerning your joints, concerning your back, concerning your health. In the name of Jesus, we release the anointing to remove every burden, to destroy every yoke that would bind you in Jesus' name. We command you, take your hands off of God's people in this house. Take your hands off. While they're watching, take your hands off. God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. And I just heard the Holy Spirit. The symptoms may not go away right away, but I'm going to tell you right now, as you go, as those lepers did, as they go, as you go praising, as you go to testify. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord God. Father, we thank you. We believe the report of the Lord today. We believe the report of the Lord today. We be in the church. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. We are the church. We are the church of the living God. Therefore, we believe his report. We believe his word. We stand on it in faith. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Somebody say, I'm expecting it. I'm expecting it in the name of Jesus. Come on, tell. Look at somebody and say, I'm expecting it. There shall be a performance of the word of God. Hallelujah. God has spoken. And any sickness has been spoken over me, the word of God that says I'm healed, arrested now. In the name of Jesus, we're healed by his stripes. He's in our midst. There's a city. There's a river. Hallelujah. There's a stream. There's a river flowing now. There's a stream flowing now. There's a stream and a river of refreshing. There's a river of restoration. There's a river of healing and deliverance that's flowing. In the name of Jesus, somebody say flow river. Flow stream, hallelujah. We release it to flow in your homes. We release it to flow all where you are in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Begin to release it wherever you are. Let it flow down in the streets of your neighborhoods in the name of Jesus. We release it to flow into our communities, in our schools. Yeah, glory to God. Yeah, yeah. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. There's a river. Hallelujah. You are a river. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. I command the rivers in you to flow also in the name of Jesus. And I speak to those rivers that's dried up. I speak now that you are being connected spiritually to other rivers, and they are going to supply you now in the name of Jesus. Thank you for a supply. Thank you for a supply, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. There's a river flowing. Hallelujah. You are in our midst, Father. You are in our midst, oh God. You are in our midst, Lord God. Hallelujah. You are in our midst. The Lord our God is in the midst of us. Thank you, Jesus. Woosha. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Thank you, Lord God. Yes, flow over our souls, flow over our unsaved loved ones, flow over them and lead them to the cross. Hallelujah. Flow in the name of Jesus. Flow rivers, flow streams. Hallelujah. You're bringing forth life. I see dead things coming to life. I see these waters flowing over parched land in the name of Jesus, flowing over parched ground. Not only was it parched, but it was hot. Hallelujah. There was no life. But I thank God now that the rivers are flowing, the streams are flowing, and life is springing forth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I see green life. Thank you, Lord God. I see fruitful trees. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. The devil told you you wasn't going to produce anymore, but you're going to produce. 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 You're going to produce out of this house. Hallelujah. You're going to produce spiritual things. You're going to produce spiritual fruit in the name of Jesus. The fruit of the Spirit, hallelujah, is springing forth from you right now. You're going to love like never before. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. You're going to love like never before. You're going to have more peace. You're going to have more long-suffering. You're going to have more temperance, more joy. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you. Thank you. Whoa, Jesus. Woo, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Glory, 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 glory. Woo, God is good. Woo, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. God, there's nothing like your power. Nothing like your power. Hallelujah. And we need your Spirit. Holy Spirit, we need you in our midst. We need you to speak to us. We need you to give us what to say. We need you to have full control. We just ministered on last week. Hallelujah. We've got the power. The power has been given unto us. The power is activated within us. Hallelujah. And yes, we can do. We can do what? All things through Christ, which gives us the strength to do it. Hallelujah. So we thank you for the wherewithal, Lord God. We thank you for the mindset to do what you declare for us to do in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Woo, my, 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 my. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I see swelling going down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Swelling. Swelling, swelling in the name of Jesus, swelling in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, enough in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, hallelujah. Woo, Jesus, 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 thank you. Yeah, yeah, I receive that Holy Spirit. Now, give us the wisdom so that we'll know what to consume and what not to consume in these temples in the name of Jesus. Just lift your hands right now for the anointing of God to fall on us in regard to what we put in these temples. Help us, Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. Give us the strength. Give us the wisdom to know what to feed these temples. Hallelujah. Help us to release that's not good for us. In the name of Jesus. God, I thank you for your anointing that is at work right now. That's giving us the strength. Hallelujah. Giving us the wisdom. You are in us. We've got the power. Hallelujah. We thank you right now concerning our diets, concerning our appetites, Lord God. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are moving within us even now in the name of Jesus. You are changing appetites. Thank you that you're being released, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Into our respiratory and digestive systems in the name of Jesus. Take full control, Lord. Hallelujah. Of what goes into this body in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you now. We release ourselves into your hands. We yield ourselves, Lord God. And Father, where we think we can't, we say we can. We think we can't, but we say we can. Therefore, we can, Lord God, because you said that we can. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. So for the next 7 days, for somebody that God is talking to, there is to be a drastic change concerning what goes in your mouth. A drastic change. And no way he's going to say it's to be a drastic change and he can't do it. If he says it, then he can do it. Increase your water. Increase your fruits and vegetables. Limit your salts and processed foods. I'm just flowing in the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, Jesus. Woo, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. I'm not trying to tell you he's getting ready to put you on no specific diet. I don't hear anything about that. All I hear is there has to be a drastic change. From the way we've been eating. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We receive that. Somebody say, I receive that. Somebody say, I receive that. And we bind the spirit of influence that would try to influence you, hallelujah, to not carry out what the Holy Spirit has spoken. Because he has spoken. Long life and length of days, God is going to grant unto us. Long life and length of days. We're going to live and not die. We're going to declare the works of the Lord. He's going to satisfy me with long life. Say it for yourself. Say, God is going to satisfy me with long life. And I'm going to help and do my part. I'm going to watch my diet. I'm going to allow the Holy Spirit to change my appetite. In the name of Jesus. Come on, lift your hands for that. Lift your hands for that, because let me tell you something. Yielding to the flesh, hallelujah. You got to lift your hands and totally give that to God. Just totally give that to God. But I'm telling you, there's life in it today. There's life in it today. There's life in it. There's change in it for you in the name of Jesus. Over these next 7 days, let there be change for you. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Let there be change in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let there be change. Woo! Thank you, Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Woo, let there be change. Let there be change. We thank you, Lord God. We have the mind of Christ. Somebody say, I got the mind of Christ. I have the mind of Christ. I'm not going to struggle with this. I am not going to struggle with this because the Holy Spirit has spoken. Not going to struggle with this. The Holy Spirit has spoken. The Holy Spirit has spoken. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Yes, he's able to do exceeding abundantly above all we ask or think, according to what? The power that's at work on the inside of us. So he is in us. Remember, we're not alone. I'm not throwing up the black power sign. I'm showing you my man that says, according to John 14, 15, 16, we've been given the Holy Ghost. The Comforter has been sent. Amen. We're not by ourselves. And so we can do this in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody praise the Lord as you take your seat. Oh, glory. Thank you, Lord God. As you take your seats, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit, we thank you today. We thank you today. Thank you, Father. This is your service. So we thank you that you have your way in your service in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. We just want to yield to you. We know it's Mother's Day. Hallelujah. But you are our Father and our Mother. Hallelujah. So we want to yield to you. We want to hear what you have to say to us. We want to have ears to hear today. Thank you, Lord God. Yeah. I'll go ahead and say that now. Thank you, Father. I want to say this to somebody, whether you're in here, whether you're watching me. I want you to stop spending time grieving over what you don't have, or over what someone has done or has not done concerning you. I'm going to speak to some mothers now. If you have children and you're feeling, you know, they're not recognizing me. They're not giving me honor. They're not honoring me on this day. Listen, this is a day. Yes, we thank God that it's been set aside. But let me tell you something. God's got 364 more days in a whole year where he will honor you. And I want you to know today we rise up and call you blessed. So do not. Don't be grieved. Don't let your heart be troubled. I want you to rise up out of that in the name of Jesus. And I want you to look around and behold the beauty and goodness of God. That's all around you. And that's for mothers or anybody. Do not have a heavy heart today or any day about who left you or who did this to you. Don't do it. Receive the blessings of God. Receive the manifold promises of God. Hallelujah. Receive everything that he has for you. Because let me tell you something, they are so great. His blessings are so great towards us that we have no need to be sorrowful. That's a trick of the enemy. It's a trick of the enemy. That'll have you sad. That'll have you down thinking about what somebody didn't do. They didn't do this for me. But look at what he's done for you. There's no way we can outbeat God giving, showing love, or whatever. Amen? We just can't do it. Hallelujah. God is good and worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. That's why we bless him. Yes. So no regrets. Lift up the head that's bowed down. Raise the hands that are hanging low and understand that you serve a good God. We serve a good God. Hallelujah. Nothing's too, we confess it. God, there's nothing too hard for you. You can do all things. We can do all things. All things are possible. Guess what? If he said it, if it's in this word, we hold it as truth. Amen. We hold it as true. That's how much he loves us. He loves us so much. And I want to get to some of these scriptures that I found. I want to first say, Happy Mother's Day. Hallelujah. Happy Mother's Day to all mothers. Even those of you, I like to say it. Well, you know, Pastor, we don't have no children. But you know what? If you have ever in your lifetime babysat, looked after, even in church, whatever. You've mothered somebody's child in some type of way. Amen? So, happy Mother's Day to you. We just thank God for you. We do. And as I was saying, well, can we tell the Father happy Mother's Day? We can. We thank him for this day because we've been created in God's likeness, in his image. Amen. Because of his nature, we know of his love. We know of his compassion. We know of his kindness. All the attributes that we think concerning mothers, that is our Father. Hallelujah. So since we are in his image and in his likeness, his word so clearly, there are so many demonstrations in the word that I found where God just brings out the goodness of God concerning us in that nature. Amen. In that motherly way. Listen to this. In Deuteronomy 32 and 18, it says, you were unmindful of the rock that bore you. You forgot the God that gave you birth. My. Hallelujah. Hosea 11:3-4 says this: God, yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk. I who took them up in my arms, but they did not know that I healed them. I led them with cords of human kindness, with bands of love. I was to them like those who lift up infants to their cheeks. I bent down to them and fed them. Sounds like what mothers do to children to me. Amen. Hosea 13:8 says this: like a bear robbed of her cubs. Y'all know how mamas give them their message. We already talked about this. Like a bear robbed of her cub, I will attack them and tear them asunder. Mess with my children if you want to. Hallelujah. He's proven that so many times over and over again in the word of God. Like the eagles in Deuteronomy 32, it says, like the eagle that stirs up the nest and hovers over its young, God spreads wings to catch you and carries you on pinions. That's what God does for us. He spreads his wings over us to catch us. Hallelujah. To bear us up. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah 66:13 says, God, as a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. You shall be comforted in Jerusalem. And we can use that in our time. You can be comforted wherever you are. Welcome back. Welcome back. I pray you were blessed. Amen. Again, we want to say, mothers, we pray that you have an awesome day today, that you just enjoy this day in the Lord. You are a Proverbs 31 woman. Who can find one? Listen, we don't have to look far. We can just look right in our homes, and there you are. We love you in the Lord today. We thank God for you. Listen, if you want to be a partner with us, we want you to just go to our website at soulgatheringministries.org, or you can call us at 501-773-1400. Also, you're going to get some information right after this broadcast. And for those of you who have already partnered with us, we thank God for you and pray the blessings of God rest upon you in Jesus' name. We will see you next week at the Master's feet. Be blessed.
Thank you for joining our program at the Master's feet with Pastor Regina Moore. Soul Gathering Ministries is located at 7600 South University Avenue in Little Rock, Arkansas. For more information, call 501-773-1400 or go to soulgatheringministries.org. You may also email us at soulgatheringministries@yahoo.com. Join us next week for another inspiring word from Pastor Regina Moore.